Let me tell you a little bit about what Rust is about.
Rust is a secret weapon.
Rust is a community project.
Rust has learned from the mistakes of the past.
Rust is a systems programming language that is safe, concurrent, and fast.
I've got one word for you. Rust.
Asking your programmers to write security-sensitive software in a language from the 1960s is like asking your dentist to go back to using the tools that they had at the turn of the last century.
You know, we have this constant stream of security vulnerabilities being reported on the internet. Every week there's a new crisis, and almost all of these are due to flaws in the construction of the software.
And that's because C++ doesn't really give you that many safety checks. In order to do it at all, you have to understand everything. If you don't understand everything, then you may make some kind of mistake, and that kind of mistake would compromise the entire program. And Rust as a language was designed to solve a lot of these problems, or at least to alert you to them as soon as you write the program. And I was always rather skeptical that this would actually be possible, or that this would be really useful to me as, you know, a sort of non-researchy, you know, systems programmer. But the thing that really turned me around was actually writing Rust code myself and realizing that, you know, I would write some program and I would think it would be totally correct. And then I would compile it, and the compiler would instantly tell me, like, you forgot this case.
It'll say, no, you shouldn't do it that way. This will end poorly, and it won't let you go on until you've made it right.
And that kind of, like, instant checking and instant feedback is just so valuable. The sooner that you detect an error, the less it costs you.
Another thing that makes Rust accessible in the system space compared to existing systems languages is that it's very modern. Right, so Rust comes out of the box with a package manager called Cargo, a central library ecosystem.
Cargo makes it absolutely easy to start a new project in Rust, to deploy that project to crates.io, to make use of other third-party projects that exist in the crates.io ecosystem.
This is something that high-level languages like Python or JavaScript take for granted, but it's a pretty powerful addition to the systems programming world.
So manual memory management is something that a lot of people have never really experienced in terms of their programming in Ruby or JavaScript or Python, and they've just kind of had this garbage collector take care of it.
When a language cleans up after you, it has to stop, look through all of the memory, and decide what is and is not in use. And the time it goes through to free up what's not in use anymore is called a garbage collection pause. In a garbage collected language, you really can't get away from that pause. And it becomes visible to the users if you're running garbage collected code on sufficiently low power hardware, like a cheap phone.
But having this ability to manually control what resources you have allocated allows you to write in all these really esoteric and interesting environments. You don't have to bring along this entire garbage collector or this big runtime, but rather you're very lightweight and you can integrate with anything and basically anything that exists.
Rust is enabling because it provides zero cost abstractions. A lot of the new features that have come along in programming languages usually have some kind of cost associated with them, right? Like, they can give you extra security checking, but your program's going to run a little bit slower.
The concept of Rust is giving you the same abstraction in terms of what you program against, but there's no cost. At compile time, everything goes away, and it all gets down to the bare metal of what you would have written anyway.
Basically, they impose no overhead over what you might write by hand.
By having this gradient of low level and safety, you can have more developers able to dive down into the stack.
And they find that actually when they get involved with a project that's written in Rust, there is really no limit to the kinds of things that they're able to work on.
One debate you hear a lot about these days is between web applications on the one hand versus native apps. And there's this sense that it's very hard for web apps to compete with the performance and responsiveness of native. We see a future where you can use things like ASM.js as a way of compiling Rust code side by side with code you're writing in JavaScript. So you write the majority of your app in JavaScript, the most performance critical bits in Rust. Rust gives you great safety guarantees that are, you know, similar to what you get in JavaScript, so your app isn't crashing all over the place like it might be if you were trying to do this with C++. But you do the whole thing on the web platform. So that's one way we see Rust helping the sort of battle between web and native apps.
This concept of working at this low level has been reserved for the select few in the past, these wizards behind the curtain.
We can welcome a whole new generation of systems programmers. All of a sudden, you can write this super high performance code and it doesn't break.
An exciting thing for me has been seeing, as one by one, engineers at Mozilla start to give Rust a try and really fall in love with it.
Come to Rust and you feel like you suddenly have superpowers.
I love Rust.
Congratulations on starting Rust.
Go try Rust.